Crazy Normal. Written by Daymond the Writer. Read for you by Angela Ohlfest. Once Sandra heard her husband start his sedan and drive from their cul-de-sac, she rose from their king-size bed and rushed into their large master bathroom. And after relieving her very heavy bladder and then washing her hands, she strayed to a large decorative window within the elegant restroom. The sight of dead autumn leaves swirling beneath an alabaster sky intensified a longing that Sandra had been experiencing for some time. She yearned to feel something, an excitement, a burst of inspiration, anything to get her through her day. Seasonal depression, she figured, before longing for spring's return. She'd traveled out of state last spring to visit her mother and missed her tree's bloom into her favorite season. Or maybe, she thought again, this is just plain old depression. Sandra returned her mind to the restroom and sauntered to the medicine cabinet. She swung her reflection away and grabbed her prescription bottle of lithium. And after pouring a couple of tablets into her hand, she looked them over and thought about being normal and how these pills were a three-time daily reminder that she wasn't. She let out a harsh sigh, returning the pills into the bottle, never taking them, and then the bottle into the cabinet. After swinging the mirrored cabinet door closed, she stared at her reflection as traces of fear began to burgeon within. But Sandra stuck to her guns. She would not be taking her meds today. And if all went well, she'd never be taking them again. From there, Sandra got on with her morning. She did a few sessions of yoga, wrote in her journal, and then extrapolated what she wrote into a poem. She'd been doing that routine since she was a teenager, when it was prescribed to her by the therapist she was seeing at the time. The therapist had instructed teenage Sandra to take note of the random thoughts and/or emotions that emerged during yoga and to explore them in her journal. Then, for extra credit, the therapist suggested that Sandra create works of art based on her discoveries. Teenage Sandra humored her therapist by writing poems, figuring the art of poetry to be the least demanding of any art she'd be willing to partake. But moments after getting into her very first poem, Sandra began to appreciate how the process of crafting out a work that could accurately express what she experienced within forced her to take notice of and then organize her thinking in a way she never would have considered otherwise. She enjoyed the routine so much. Writing became a passion that inspired her to start a blog. A blog that eventually garnered a modest income, also to Sandra's surprise. But before Sandra received a cent from any blog post, she noticed how the routine helped her at least feel as if she had a handle on her life. And as far as Sandra was concerned, a modicum of control was all she needed. Although, according to her therapist back then, and many others since, she also needed the lithium. Over the years, Sandra wondered if she could cope without the prescription, but decided today would be the day she'd actually find out. She didn't care if her husband agreed, or if he ratted her decision to her current therapist. She wanted to be normal, and normal people didn't take lithium. Besides, Sandra had a sneaking suspicion that something was off. She didn't know if the disparity was in her marriage, or in some other part of her life. But somehow, she knew ridding herself of the prescribed element would be a good step in determining the discrepancy. After gaining clarity from her faithful routine, Sandra posted a new blog and then cleaned every inch of her and her husband's colonial home. She scrubbed every toilet, mopped every tile, and vacuumed every carpet. She also dusted the surfaces and polished the wood. Then, after a soothing shower that relieved the residual concern she had for her medicine, Sandra dressed into that comfortable set of joggers and entered the kitchen.